Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We've learned about how to convert alcohols into leaving groups, and primarily halides is what we discussed. We talked about all kinds of methods to go from an alcohol to a halide. Now let's talk about a different kind of a leaving group, a tosylate as well as mesylates. So what is a tosylate? Well, tosylates are involve this group called a tosyl group. And the tosyl group is kind of an exotic thing. It's a sulfur with a couple oxygens, and the tosylate specifically is a benzene ring with a methyl group. And if you want to get formal about it, it's para-toluene sulfonyl. But people don't walk around saying para-toluene sulfonyl. They just say tosyl. And the abbreviation for tosyl is TS. It's capital T, lowercase s. So tosyl chloride is TsCl, and that keeps that saves us from having to draw the structure. However, know that TsCl, that Ts stands for that big structure. Mesylate is very closely related. It's a little bit smaller, but it also has a sulfur with two double bonds to oxygens and another R group, except it's a methyl group instead of this big benzene ring thing. So we call that mesyl chloride instead of its formal name, methane sulfonyl chloride. And so that's equals MsCl, capital S, lowercase, capital M, lowercase s. So how do we use this reagent? Well, both these reagents react with alcohols in the presence of a fairly weak base. So here is a secondary alcohol. Doesn't have to be a secondary alcohol. Could be primary, could be tertiary. And in this case, I've reacted this with tosyl chloride. That's our reagent to make a tosylate. And pyridine. Sometimes people write pyridine as PYR. This is the structure of pyridine. This nitrogen has a lone pair. It's a little bit basic because this reaction forms HCl, and we need a base to kind of soak up and react with that, neutralize that HCl. So what happens is the H on the alcohol is replaced by the TS group. So we get this OTS. This is our tosylate. So we convert our alcohol into a tosylate, or our alcohol into a mesylate. So this is a really good leaving group. So now once we form our tosylate, we can perform any of our substitutions and eliminations on this particular molecule because we've now converted our poor leaving group alcohol into a good leaving group, the tosylate. Note that this chemistry, it's super mild. There's not a whole lot of acid in here. That's a good thing for the reaction. It also doesn't affect the stereochemistry of our alcohol, because all the chemistry really is happening out on the oxygen, not the carbon center. So this gives us certain control of stereochemistry that we don't have with reagents like HBr or thionyl chloride, SOCl2. So why is tosylate such a good leaving group? Because, you know, we can see why things like bromide might be a good leaving group. It's a big atom. It's electronegative. Helps it hold the charge. But we always said hydroxide's bad. And hydroxide's a strong base. Well, when tosylate leaves, we're going to form, this is our leaving group. What makes this O minus so much better than hydroxide? Well, let's draw the structure, kind of a minimized structure, just with an R group. So this is now our leaving group. This is what's going to leave when our nucleophile reacts. Let's say azide reacts with this. It's going to kick that out. This is our leaving group. Why is that so stable? Well, there's a lot of resonance that we can draw because of these neighboring sulfur-oxygen bonds. That gives us a lot of delocalization of charge and makes this anion really stable. Stable anions or stable groups make good leaving groups, and this is certainly a stable group. So tosylates and mesylates are really mild ways to make alcohols into leaving groups. I'd say you're going to encounter tosylates a whole lot more often than mesylates, but mesylates do pop up here and there, especially if you're looking around the internet. So that's how another way to make alcohols into good leaving groups, convert them into tosylates or mesylates.